Ooh, so today Apple has released iOS 17.1, and it's a super important update bringing new features like AirDrop over cellular and changes like fixing the overheating issues and extending battery life to the iPhone 15 series devices. So let's talk about all the new stuff in iOS 17.1 and why you should update. Okay, so first things first, let's start off with what's new, and let's begin by going into the Settings app. Go into the Settings app, then to General, then to AirDrop, and at the very bottom here, you'll see a new option called Use Cellular Data. Now, if you turn this option on, essentially what this will allow you to do is continue to AirDrop files over your cellular data when you move away from that person. So let's say it's like a large video file or a large media file. You can continue to AirDrop that person even when you step away just by using your cellular data. Now, an added thing specifically with AirDrop is now faster, in my opinion, when transferring files. I don't know what it is, but to me, AirDrop seems to be a little bit more smooth, a little bit faster, and I'm just having a way better overall experience using AirDrop versus what I was experiencing in iOS 17. Now, another new feature is if you go into the battery menu, and as you can see, I have something charging here via my USB-C cable. If you go into the battery menu, you can now see statistics on essentially what your battery is doing. So if you look here, you'll see that battery is charging, and then you'll see a kind of drop off here when it's not connected to a charger. Now you can actually see when you're charging other devices and how much power you are sending to those devices. So go ahead, when you charge something, check the battery menu and see exactly how much battery that has taken up when you are charging your device via a USB-C cable. Okay, so now when you go into the standby menu in iOS 17.1, you can see this menu has completely changed versus iOS 17. So now you have kind of this new display menu, which gives you several different options as to how you can customize your standby display. Now we have three new options here as to turn display off. So automatically, after 20 seconds and never. Automatically is kind of the best option because it's the intelligent mode option, which the iPhone will detect if lights are off, no movement, no usage. It will turn your display off so it's not continuously on all night displaying that standby feature. Obviously, when there's movement, when there's light or anything like that, the display will intelligently turn on when you are ready to view your standby display. You also have night mode option down here, which we had before, and motion to wake as well. So go ahead, check out the new standby menu and the new features for standby. Okay, so some really cool wallpaper customizations options here in iOS 17.1. I'm gonna go ahead and demo one of those new features. If you go ahead and add a wallpaper and then go to Photoshop, Shuffle, then select album, and I'm going to select my wallpaper album. So you can see here, I have my wallpaper album, and I can go to shuffle frequency, on tap, on lock, hourly, and daily. I'm going to do on tap just for this demo here. And now you can see I have all of my wallpapers that I specifically want for my wallpapers to be displayed on my iPhone. I have all of those set. And before, you had to kind of like set each one and swipe through different lock screens and everything like that. You'd have maybe 10 lock screens for different wallpapers because you want them to switch. Now you can do it all through one via Photo Shuffle. I'm gonna go ahead and use album. Perfect. And now I'm going to add that. Awesome. And now when I go ahead and delete those, I can tap and I can tap through different wallpapers through that wallpapers album that I have set up. So this is a cool and handy new feature here in iOS 17.1. Now, another really cool wallpaper specific handy feature here in iOS 17.1 is when you go into customize a wallpaper specifically, you now have a new option called extend wallpaper here. So essentially this will allow you to extend your wallpaper to fit kind of like the guides of your iPhone, whatever iPhone you have, specific for iPhone like 15 Pro Max users or any iPhones that are like the plus version. This is a great new feature to allow you to extend that wallpaper to fit your screen. So you can essentially make any picture fit your specific phone. Okay, so a new dynamic island feature here is if you go ahead and turn your flashlight on, you can see here that it will continuously stay on at the top of that dynamic island when your flashlight is on, just kind of indicating that something is on. If I go ahead and expand this menu on the right-hand side, it'll show that it's on. But on the left-hand side, you can actually tap that kind of like flashlight icon to turn the flashlight off. You don't have to go back into the control center. So go ahead, tap it, and it's completely off. As you can see here, it's off. So that's kind of a new handy trick here, specifically for the flashlight icon or the flashlight feature. I'd love for this feature to be expanded into other things, but that is a fresh start here for iOS 17.1. Now, another thing with Dynamic Island here is that if you go into reachability mode, let's go ahead and activate that. So before, you used to see a dynamic island up here. It used to be like the wallpaper, and the dynamic island would show up here, and then it would show down here as well. And now Apple has just placed it down here and made all of this section here at the top black, making that so you don't have two dynamic islands and it looks kind of weird. So that's just a new kind of like fix here in iOS 17.1 specific to the dynamic island. Okay, so specific to the Apple Watch here, the new double tap feature has been brought to watchOS 10.1 for the Apple Watch Ultra 2 and also the Apple Watch Series 9. So if I go ahead and activate my watch here, I can use the new double tap feature. And you can see I can cycle through different things. So the double tap feature is really cool, really handy when you only have one hand to use, and you can use it to answer phone calls, check text messages, stuff like that. Now, another cool new feature is name drop has been brought to the Apple Watch specifically. So if you go ahead and bring like an iPhone close, you can see that it's trying, but obviously this is my own Apple Watch. This is my phone, so it's not exactly going to work, but you can see that the name drop AirDrop feature is now working here in watchOS 10.1 in coordination with iOS 17.1. So the fixes. If you have an iPhone 15 and your iPhone has been overheating, this update now fixes that issue through better chip management and not allowing certain things to essentially overload your processor into continuously working without cooling down. Now, another issue that people were having was the action button was being mistakenly activated when in their pocket. Now, in iOS 17.1, when a phone is in your pocket or maybe in your bag, the length of time it needs to be pressed has been increased, making the action button more secure when your phone is in your pocket or maybe in a bag somewhere. Now, the last functional change is the keyboard. Oh my goodness, the keyboard was big time lagging in iOS 17.1 or iOS 17, that is. And now in iOS 17.1 with this update, that keyboard lag is now gone. So you don't need to worry about all those mistypes and mistakes when using the keyboard. Now, some things that we are still waiting for are the journal app. Apple previewed the journal app during the iOS 17 announcement, but we have yet to see it in iOS 17 betas or even now the iOS 17.1 release. I suspect that that will be released in iOS 17.2 betas along with some other smaller features as well, so stay on the lookout for that. And the other two things that people have really been pushing for are the battery cycle count and 80% limit options for non-iPhone 15 devices. Now, in my opinion, there's no reason why these options can't be made for older devices. The battery cycles is just essentially like a cycle count, which every iPhone stores. So why not bring it to the settings menu? And as for the 80% limit, again, not really something that is limited by a chip. Seemingly, Apple should be adding these to iOS 17.2. So yeah, I suspect that if those two features do come for older devices specifically, it's likely to be perhaps in like iOS 17.2 or even the iOS 17.3 update if Apple just doesn't have anything else to put in those updates. So guys, that is iOS 17.1, the update and all of what's new and all that has changed and reasons why you should be updating your own personal device. Hope you all enjoyed today's video and we'll see you in the next one.